lesson that Enduring Cancer's taught me, and that lesson is that for every loss, there's a gain. For every down, there's an up, and for every dark day, there will be another day with sun. Cancer taught me about the balance and the yin-yang of life, but my biological family, my friends, and my cancer family taught me that the key to success was to focus on the gains and not the losses and be ignorant of the bad stuff. Waiting in the suite, however, was sometimes long and aggravating, and it was during one of these times that I came up with my own stages for cancer. And they are as follows. Stage one, you're a patient. Stage two, you're a soldier. Stage three, you're a survivor. And stage four, you become a Canadian Cancer Society volunteer, fundraiser, or supporter. I did have some bad days, and I had my share of crying fits, snapping or being uncooperative with doctors and nurses, thoroughly embarrassing my family at times. But I just kept reminding myself that the worse that it was now, the better it was going to be in the future. I kept a journal and a blog during my journey, and one of the things I promised myself was that every time I wrote something negative down, I would find the good side and I would find the positive side. And there are a few small lessons that I learned that I'd like to share with you now, because no matter what cancer you've been through, and no matter what your journey is like, I think has been like for you, I think that we can all relate in some ways. For example, I was treated at the Jurevinsky Cancer Center in Hamilton, which happens to be part teaching hospital. So every time I had an appointment, my doctor was accompanied by some young, hot medical student. And within minutes of shaking his hand, I was told to assume the position, hands down, butt in the air. First few times, I was horrified and completely humiliated. But the more I went, I decided to focus less on the loss of my humility and more on the lesson gained, which was the ability to let my guard down and to see my body and its functions for what they are as part of being human. So I just started to wear cuter underwear, and I drew a couple smiley faces on my bum just to ease the tension. We are the lucky ones. We are the lucky ones because so many of our fellow soldiers don't make it to the other side. But we can honor them in the way that we live our lives after cancer. When you get to hear those joyous words, your most recent test came back clean, and we feel we have eradicated your cancer. It feels like someone drew up the shades and the world is revealed from black and white to color for the first time. I don't take anything for granted anymore. I love faster, forgive easily, I laugh always, I taste and try food. I'm more sensitive and I listen longer. I stand up for myself and voice my opinion. I'm knowledgeable about my body and what it takes to keep it healthy. I don't sweat the small stuff and I don't wait for a special occasion to wear fancy clothes because every day is special. And finally, I participate in events like this one. And an event where we honor ourselves, each other, the loved ones we've lost, the volunteers, the nurses, the doctors, our family, and our supporters by paying it forward. They say when life gives you lemons, choose to make lemonade. So when life gave us cancer, we chose to make a difference. And that's finally the Cancer Club I am proud to be a part of.
That's the reason we're here tonight.